So we are now moving on to agenda item number 10, Terramore Development.
All right, thank you, Madam Chairman. This one is a rezoning request to rezone two parcels of land totaling 2.34 acres from a combination of highway commercial and R-6 to all community commercial CC. And as you see on the map on the screen and in your packet, the vast majority of this property is single-family R-6. There's a narrow strip of highway commercial along the frontage, along Griffin Avenue and South Patterson Street. As described there in your packet, that narrow strip has been there since day one, which translates means 1966 when the city adopted zoning. So this property, as well as some of the other properties you see to the north, have been split zoned from the beginning. A little easier to interpret on the digital map than it was back in the 60s and 70s when they had a paper map, where things were a little bit more distorted. Property has been vacant for a long time. The character area you see is Community Activity Center, which allows for commercial type zonings. R6 is actually allowed in CAC, but it's not a typical zoning that you can find there. Aerial imagery shows the pattern a little more vividly, the vacant nature of the site. You see a small shopping center to the north, the building on the corner where Young's comes out to South Patterson. That's an existing car wash facility. There's a small vacant line, lot behind the car wash, and that is the small parcel of the subject property. All of that is put in place to support this site. The proposal is to develop the site as a Dollar General store with two means of access, one directly onto South Patterson, and the other one on the Young's Lane, and they have a secondary means of egress to get out to South Patterson and not be right at the Griffin Avenue intersection. Site plan is there in your packet, showing the parking and the layout, lots of maneuverability for their trucks. The typical site plan that we see for Dollar General. Subject property, this is how it looks from South Patterson, looking eastward into the grass area. It's been that this way for a very long time. The only thing on the property is a nice vending machine, which has been there for a while. I'm not sure what the plans are for that, other than obviously we'll have to move somewhere. It's not showing on their site plan. But yet it could possibly fit, or it will probably more likely go to another site. Adjacent property, this is from the subject property looking southward through that intersection of Griffin Avenue and South Patterson. Looking across the street, you see some of the older intensive commercial uses on the other side of Patterson, Hardy's Restaurant to the northwest. And this is looking down Young's Lane, which is a very narrow existing street, looking eastward or the single-family neighborhood, which lies back to the east. With this one, staff has found the request consistent with the comprehensive plan, the standards for exercise of zoning power, which are there in your packet, and we are recommending approval. Glad to answer any questions you may have.
Matt, did they approve for a Dollar General around this area a couple of years ago?
Not a Dollar General. What's interesting to notice, the parcel to the north,
yes,
which is also split zone, has a Dollar Tree as one of its tenant spaces.
Okay. Commissioners, do we have any more questions for staff? All right, let's open it up to the public. Is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request, if you'll come forward?
Good evening, Commissioners. Bill Madigan, 1007 North Patterson Street. I'm here on behalf of the applicant, Terramore Development. So this property, as Mr. Martin said, is split zoned. The purpose is to bring it under one zone classification, CC. I'm sure y'all are familiar with the area. It is heavily commercial, that part of South Patterson. So this fits within the land use pattern and is consistent with the comprehensive plan. I do want to point out this will be a Dollar General store. I believe there's an existing Dollar General in Bratz Plaza, which is west. I don't know what you're thinking of, next to the Save a Lot. Yeah. So that lease will expire.
Gotcha.
This is a new store that will house that operation. It's a 12,000, roughly 12,500 square foot store, so it will have groceries, which is good.
That'd be great.
Produce, so I have meat items. And it's which is out in the market. I did have a rendering. So, Blue Dollar General does sell ice. Ice operation.
Go away.
The competition there with the ice. But this is an infill development. I mean, it's vacant land right in the city here, and should be a good project for this area. So.
Totally different facade.
I'm sorry.
Totally different facade.
I think there's one of those over in Nashville.
Yeah, I don't know if there's a DG Market in Valdosta.
No, I don't think there is. I think Nashville's the closest. Nice. That does look nice.
So we're looking at a January construction start and opening sometime in June, 2023. But I'm here to answer any questions.
I'm just curious, the city traffic engineer, they go one in, one out?
One in, and Clayton Milligan, by the way, is here from Lowndes Engineering. So if I need to pull in reinforcements to get
I'm just curious, am I missing that?
It's two in.
Yeah.
There's one off Young.
Off Young's? Okay.
There's Galen off Young.
Which
Young is a bit odd because.
Very near.
The portion of Young Street,
it's
basically
like a driveway.
From where the Dollar General drive aisle goes out onto Young right there, towards Patterson, is actually private property.
So is that technically a get out of Dodge?
It has a peculiar history.
Yeah.
It's being used as a street. We're not entirely sure it is public right of way. But we are told that as part of this development, it will, by hook or by crook, become public right.
I told you, that ice man's going to buy that lane, you know that, don't you put his ice man in there.
Any other questions for Bill? All right, thank you.
Thanks,
sir.
All right, is there anyone else tonight?
Not Clayton. I got to
say something.
Yeah.
Clayton Milligan, 3998, Interpreter. I just want to clarify a little bit on the traffic there. So there's another project, one of the TIA projects that the city's working on is completely redoing Griffin Avenue intersection. So that intersection is going to pull further south away from the site and be more of a square up instead of coming in at an angle. So we've had a lot of conversations with the folks that are working on that project along with the new city engineer. And making sure all this, if you look at the plan right now, it looks like some of the decelling overlaps. We're designing our site to line up with the new planned intersection there at Griffin Avenue. We're also working with GDOT as well to make sure all this is going to work together. So this, when all this is done, all this will be cleaned up and work on it smoother than it does now.
Is there a timeline on that?
On the TIA project?
Yeah.
So that was one thing we were working out. They'll probably be both going concurrently. They're supposed to bid that project in October, which means you're probably looking at a January start for that project as well.
So it's going to dead end into Patterson? I mean, a square, so there's going to be a light there?
So right now, it comes in an angle
where
you see those two
turnabouts,
the whole road is going to turn quicker, but where it comes in at a 90-degree angle.
The proposed rendering on here also.
Correct.
The
deselling that we drew in, you couldn't build it like we're showing it now, but it works with the future plan. We can only overlay the main plan on the
Good deal.
Thank you. All right. Is there anyone here tonight who would like to speak against this request if you'll come forward? Anyone wishing to speak against this request? All right, if not, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any discussion or questions from staff. And there being none, I'll ask for a motion.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
Press this thing to VA-2022-18. The request is to rezone two parcels of land totaling 2.34 acres from single-family residential R-6 to highway commercial. I'll make a motion that we approve the request this evening.
Okay, point of clarification, it is actually from R-6 and CH, all
okay.
to CC.
I apologize.
Okay.
So if you stated that, I'm good with that?
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Matt, you good with that?
Yes, sir.
If Madam Chair corrected me on something,
you read it. I'm sure it'll be reflected in that.
Thank you, sir.
Madam Chair, about a second.
All right. All right, we have a motion to approve by Commissioner Bailey, seconded by Commissioner Graham. Any comments or discussion on the motion?
You said edited by Madam Chair.
And edited by me. All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against, and that motion.